Welcome. The next topic I want to talk about is soils. First, a little definition. What is soil? It's the very uppermost layer of the Earth's surface, and it has both mineral and organic matter capable of supporting plants. So when we say organic matter, we mean it comes from the living material above the ground, such as vegetation, trees, leaves, roots, grasses, and so on. And the mineral material is the rock material. So it's a mixture of rock and living things, essentially. So broken up rock and living things together combined and make soil, which is necessary for terrestrial plant life or land plant life. Now, one thing to note about soil is in the introduction to geography, we often talk about these different spheres: the atmosphere, hydrosphere, lithosphere, and biosphere. And soil is really kind of integrates all of these. It exchanges gases with the atmosphere. Water flows and is stored in the soil. It is, living things contribute to the soil, as do rock material as well. One topic, so when you study soils, there's two different ways to approach it. One is more of a plant science, or how to, enrich your soil to grow food. And in geography, we often focus more on pedology. And this is the study of the formation, morphology, and classification of soils. Morphology being, what is the classification, or what is the physical appearances of the soil? What is the structure of the soil? And classification of soils within a natural landscape. And there's different factors that will influence that, namely climate, organisms, parent material, which is really the rock material that goes into the soil, topography and slope, and time. So let's take a quick look at some of those factors. One is climate. The climate conditions can affect the structure of your soil. These are called horizons or layers, and you may have differences in horizons or layers depending if you're in a wet climate or a dry climate. Organisms add organic material to the soil, so the presence of vegetation or even things like worms can affect your soil. Where your parent material comes from, that's the rock portion of your soil, can make a difference as well. For example, in California, we're here in the Central Valley. We have the Sierra Nevada mountain range on one side and the coast ranges on the other. Each one is made of different types of rock material, more granite here in the Sierra Nevada, more sedimentary type rocks in the coastal range. And so the parent material over on one side of the valley comes more from the material that comes down from the Sierra Nevada. And on the other side, it's influenced more by the material that comes from the coast ranges. So the soils on the west side of the valley have different parent material than soils on the east side of the valley. Slope can play a role as well. If you're in the mountains and you're on a steep slope, you will tend to have a thinner soil than if you are in a flat area. And importantly, time. That soil development, it happens over a long period of time. So when you just have fresh parent material or the rock material, it takes a while to develop into a fully mature soil. So we'll talk about horizons of the soil later. And one thing to be mindful of is that they just don't happen immediately. They can take hundreds to thousands of years to develop a fully mature soil.